Parkdale was like in the 1890s. With the manners, the little things like, what will the neighbors say? Spring memories, okay? And that kind of social attitude. So it's a wonderful book to get an insight into the neighborhood. And this was, her name at that time was Maisie Roach. And it became, when she became an author, of course, Mazel Deloach, same person. Fascinating. And here she lived with her grandfather and her grandmother and her mom and her dad and her cousin and her uncle. It was a typical extended family home. So I can say Victorians had a thing. They loved Goth, every kind of revival architecture you could think of. And they always felt, why have one when you can have five or six? So we're going to go next door and look at a perfect example of that.
Design at the Ontario Science Center. This is his project. He's been working on it for a long time.
Take a look. At the very bottom, it's got Roman columns. Above it, it's got a Gothic roof with a ship's wheel. Off to the others, to your right, is a Romanesque 11th century window with a 19th century stained glass window in it. Above it is a 17th century Queen Anne revival, what's called an oriel, which is a second story bay window that doesn't have a bay window below it. It's a freestanding bay. Above that, it's got arts and crafts top, the peaked roof, the barn board, that whole style, and the double windows, etc., is classic arts and crafts, which is started in the Middle Ages and then is replicated in the 1920s. So it was a high-end rental right from the beginning. And also it was a British thing, because British often didn't own their homes, they rented them. That was a very typical middle class and upper middle class thing, is to rent, not own. That's why in Britain they have landlords. They were real lords that owned the land. Now, a wonderful example of just that terrific mix of architecture. So if you ever want to study the history of architecture, just stand in front of this building. It's all there. Just a beautiful example. And it's also an example because later on, after it had been a private residence, it turned into a rooming house, and then eventually Mr. Smith bought it and brought it back, so it's a single family. He brought it right back so it looked exactly like it did over 100 years ago, because it was built in 1898.